New at 11, a common social media app has some parents worried about child exploitation.
CBS 46's Rob Hughes tells you what you need to know to keep your kids safe.
What I ended up learning was daunting. It's probably fairly inappropriate to talk about some of the things that I read.
Father of three, Travis Rawlings says he thought he had it all figured out when it came to monitoring his kids' phones.
We check what we use. We check Facebook. We check text messages. We're checking phone calls.
But last week, he says this unsuspecting little yellow icon got his attention.
There was an app called Yubo, Y-U-B-O, that is just pinging the phone. And I didn't know what it was.
This is what it looks like in the App Store. The app is called Yubo. It markets itself as a social live streaming app, but others tout it as a Tinder for teens.
You can select things here and decide if you want to swipe left, swipe right. This app is engaging kids to have secret intimate lives.
Rawlings says his son started using Yubo around the same time his school went remote.
COVID has caused a lot of social breakdowns of Yubo. Kids are meant to be social, and the only way they can communicate with other kids is through apps right now.
Kathleen Nguyen, who runs an organization against sex trafficking, says Yubo is also increasingly becoming a breeding ground for child predators.
So it isn't harmless, it's harmful.
Citing a case in Florida last year where a 28-year-old man used it to meet a 13-year-old girl for sex.
Young people being preyed upon by older people to send inappropriate content.
Rawlings says what's also worrisome is most of the parents he speaks with have no clue what he's talking about.
Back to idle hands, we have teenagers at home with nothing to do, with technology available to ultimately have them secretly create relationships we have no influence over.
Rob Hughes, CBS 46 News.